Andy Newman shorthanded tonight. We'll tell you about that as we go along. Coyotes control the opening tip. They go right to left across your dial and left to right if you're watching on TV. Coyotes in the home white. Stanislaw in black. And a bounce pass to Villa is intercepted by Francois. So the Warriors come back looking for their first possession. Fennell, their leading scorer, right side, and traveling violation is before Scott could get the shot off. If you're with us on KMET Radio, we'll keep you up to date on the Laker game, which we just left early. 111-104 with 27 seconds to go. Coyotes with the ball, strong to the basket, off the glass and in. Jordan Mitchell takes it strong to the hole, and Andy wanted the foul as well, but didn't get it. 2-0 Coyotes. Coyotes in a man-to-man defense. Scott trying to get free of Mitchell. Right side three, Salgado long. Jeremy Smith tracks it down. Coyotes hurry it back the other way. Smith used Dayton as a screen. Now Mitchell. Dayton takes it low. Baseline, back it in. And a little 10-footer. Good off the glass. Nice touch. 4-0 San Bernardino. Ty Davis matched up with Smith. Sends it over here to the left. Scott goes down low. Fennell now. Back on top for the three. No. Two white shirts for the rebound. Mitchell will get it. Jennings right side. Dayton contact. Put it up. And an offensive foul. Jennings first. First team foul on San Bernardino. 18-11 to go. First half. .111-104 the final as Milwaukee beat the Lakers tonight on KMET. Happy you joined us for Cal State San Bernardino basketball. And down low in the lane, no good. Villa clears the rebound. A good look for the Warriors, and Smith coming back. Contact, count it. And let's see about the foul. It'll be a chance for a three-point play. Kevin Smith's got the foul underneath, and it'll go against Ty Davis. Coyotes start strong, 6-0. And Jeremy Smith to the line. Free throw, no good. Rebound is loose, taken by Stanislaw. .17:38 to go, first half. There's the pass into the low post. Bulldog working down low in there. And close to a three-second count. Got a whistle and a foul on the pass off. Henderson with the foul. I said a pass off, but they're going to call it on the shot, which means Luis Salgado will go to the line. Foul on Henderson, and Salgado makes it a 6-1 game. Coyotes will be home again on Saturday afternoon to finish out the calendar year. Second free throw good, 6-2. Some full court pressure as Darius Scott is back, and Smith and Mitchell will get it across. Jeremy Smith gets a screen from Bulldog, goes around it, strong to the basket, good pass. Mitchell left open left side, ring it up. A three-pointer, 9-2. Coyotes off to a strong start. Pass down low. Again, Bulldog holding his ground, and a hook shot traveling, yep. Matt Adams saw the same thing I did. So Bulldog with good defense down low. Coyote bench just got shorter, and we'll tell you more about that as we go along. It's going to be a seven-man rotation the rest of the year. Mitchell with a pass into the corner. Smith, three-point range, long, thought about it, got it. Now he was wide open, and Paul Trevor has seen enough. 12-2, Coyotes, a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. Good start for San Bernardino. C.J. Clark, the junior from Riverside City College, got injured in the game up at Monterey Bay on Saturday. He was able to come back briefly in the second half, but talked to Andy Newman before the game, and the bad news is he is out for the season with a leg injury. So it was an eight-man Coyote rotation. Now it is down to seven, and CJ becomes the third player along with Diego Womack, who got hurt in workouts before the season started, to be lost for the year. The line was eight could be enough for the Coyotes, and I said to Andy before the game, is seven going to be enough? And he said, I hope so. 12-2. Coyotes with the lead following the timeout. Fennell going to work. Pulls back for the jumper, no good. Rebound, Jennings has it. Mitchell takes the outlet pass. Waits for his teammates to join him. And Mitchell on his way to the basket called for the travel. Andy saw the contact, and it'll still be a turnover for the Coyotes. Paul Trevor up, coaching his team. 12-2. Their starters have been great. It's their bench that has been the problem. And the starters are all still out there. And Fennell down low, going across the lane, had it knocked away out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Warriors. Four of their five starters average in double figures. The problem is the bench only accounts for 10 points a game. The good news for the Coyotes, finals are over. And according to Andy Newman, everything went well for everybody. Fennell takes the inbound pass. Davis back on top. Now the shot clock didn't reset. It's at six. And Davis knows it. Puts up a 17-footer, no good. Rebound cleared. Another one for Jennings. Smith on the left this time. 4 minutes in, the pass to Jennings. Dayton facing the basket, takes a dribble. Cross court to the near side. Villa posted down low. Henderson looks in there, lobs it to him. Shot clock at 10. Bulldog facing the basket. Five, spin move off the rim, got it. Shooter's touch, 14-12, Coyotes. 5.5 minutes gone. Davis goes right. Salgado working against Henderson. Lob pass, Fennell down low, give and go underneath, and the layup put in. Xander Francois puts it in. And the other way, we've got a reaching foul and a timeout on the court. Coyote ball and a 14-4 lead for San Bernardino early. You're listening to Coyote Basketball on KMET. No, really. How'd you hear that? That's too bad. No, I didn't hear that. Mitch McClellan back with you on a Thursday night at Casulis Arena. Coyotes perfect early. 6 of 6 shooting, including 2 3-pointers. And for Stanislaw, 1 of 6, 16%. Paul Trevor and Andy Newman both know that can change in another couple minutes. And if I know Paul, what he probably said was, see what we can do in this next 4 minute segment. Coyotes with a strong start. Out rebounding them 5-1 so far. And Henderson gives it off. Smith in the corner takes a look. Goes to the dribble instead. Back to Henderson at the left elbow. 10 on the shot clock. Jennings takes the pass. Dayton baseline, double team, put it up, no good. Got his own rebound, squared up, no good, and Fennell will clear it. 14-4, and Stanislaus coming back, and a foul underneath. No, jump ball, they say. Possession arrow to Stanislaus. The shot clock will be at 23 for Ty Davis. And they had it in for a moment. Rex, who just checked into the game, tipped it out. Warriors get the inbound. Fennell with an open three, that's good. He can make that shot all day. 14-7. Dayton sets the screen. Smith goes around it. Right side, Rax. Short off the front of the rim. Rebound cleared by Fennell. Now this is Davis. And Fennell with his second quick three-pointer. That's an air ball out of bounds. So you can see what both teams tried to do. Coyotes wanted to set up Rax for a three that didn't go. And Stanislaw did the same for Fennell. 6 minutes gone. Coyotes with a 7-point lead. Smith in the front court. Jennings working down low. Rax takes a look. Goes to the drive. Dayton still in the paint. Smith going left to right. Shot clock at 12. Jeremy with the pass. Rax with the three straight away. Didn't get the roll. Rebound is loose. And coming out of there with it, Scott. And Scott open for the three, put it in. Back-to-back threes from the same side, and Andy Newman's going to make some changes. 14-10. So a 6-0 run on those two three-pointers for Stanislaw, and Rex throws it away looking for Dayton down low. Mitchell and Villa back in the game for San Bernardino. So the Warriors getting a little closer. Francois into the corner. Salgado. Bounce pass. Scott's got it. Low post against Rax on a mismatch. And he turns, scores, and is fouled. Be a chance for a three-point play. Rax with his first personal. Cameron Brown and Frank will make that Noah Plain into the game for the Warriors. Coyotes changing on defense now. Free throw good. So it's a 9-0 Warrior run. It was 14-2 Coyotes. Now 14-13. Mitchell, Smith, Lacou in the game now for the first time. Lacou, right side, open three, got it. 17-13 as Lacou lights it up for the first time. Campbell coming left, hands it off to Fennell, who uses him as a screen and makes the three. Lacou came out, but not in time. 17-16. Rax. Villa takes the pass down low. Double teamed. And the ball deflected and taken by Fennell, and a foul. Henderson in the game for the Coyotes, and Fred Lavender in for the Warriors. So Stanislaw looking for the lead this time. And an open three again. This one off the back of the rim, and Bulldog grabs the rebound. Coyotes by a point. We'll have a timeout on the next dead ball, and Smith goes all the way and lays it in. Jeremy Smith high off the glass, 19-16, Coyotes. Scott and Brown in the backcourt now. Brown, right side. This is Lavender. Scott down low. Fennell against LeCou. Fennell backs in. LeCou knocked the ball away. Fennell gets it back. And he traveled, and that'll get us to the media timeout. With 11:22 to go, and the Coyotes back on top by three, 19-16 on KMET. No, I left a message for him. Bill's got the Telos. He's going to bring it up in the morning and leave it there. We made sure John knew, so hopefully he could get up there tomorrow and put it back in, but neither one of us has heard from him yet. Minutes, 22 seconds to go. First half from Casulas Arena. Coyote shooting, which was 6-for-6 the last time we checked, is now 8-for-12. And Stanislaw, which was at 16%, up to 42. Funny how those things even out. Rebounds in favor of the Coyotes, 8-4. LeCou gives to Mitchell, double team and a blocking foul. Brown gets the foul. Third team foul. The Coyote ball on the baseline. Rex with a handoff to Mitchell. Mitchell off the glass and in. Jordan Mitchell with that good first step on the right, and the Coyotes get the lead back to 5. 21-16. San Bernardino staying in the man. Lavender looking to Fennell. On top. Plain. Brandon Thomas in the game now. Shot clock at 7. Thomas. Fennell will launch it. Short. Henderson with a rebound. And down court. Ball taken away. Half-court game again for the Warriors. Brown. Lavender right side against Henderson. Fennell now backs out. Three-point territory. Dayton with him. And Fennell goes to the drive. Tried to put it up and got fouled. Dayton with the block, they say, his second. Andy Newman's asking the officials to check and see who the foul was called on. And they're going to change it to Rax. So it'll be the second foul on Rax. And Dayton with one. Now Paul Trevor is saying, hey, why did you change it? Three throw good. Great to see Paul Trevor, who was so much a part of his program and the success here for so long. Did a great job at San Francisco State. Running the show in Turlock now. Second free throw good. 21-18. A lot of good memories with Paul Trevor, and great to see him on the sideline. Now Darnell Johnson getting a chance here now with the injury to Clark. And the jumper good as Smith hits it from 12. 23-18. Darnell Johnson is number 5 in white for San Bernardino. He's going to be the first one to see if he can be player number 8 in that rotation. Off-balance jumper from Thomas. No. Henderson coming back with it. Henderson right side. Darnell with those long arms. And foul down low. Kainoa Balunga commits the foul. Coyotes will try it again. There's the bounce pass, and it was blocked as Dayton went to the basket. Coming back, Lavender over in the left side, and it wouldn't stay down for Davis. Now Jennings coming back. Jennings with a good pass, and the layup put in by Darnell Johnson, who got down there in a hurry. Darnell Johnson, the redshirt freshman from San Diego, 25-18. And down low, Francois, no good with an air ball. Johnson grabs it. Coyotes coming back. Jeremy Smith right side. Henderson pulls up for a two-pointer, got it. Andy Smith Newman leading the cheers from the Coyotes sideline. 27-18 as the Coyotes go on their second run of the game. Davis over here to Thomas, and a turnover. It's going to be an illegal screen on Francois. .8:16 to go, first half. Finals week is over. At least finals week is over for the Coyotes. Elsewhere around the CCAA, other schools have it this week. Three other games tonight. We'll check those at halftime. Henderson, 15-footer, no. Davis. Now Thomas. And Thomas with the open three. That's good. That was an odd-looking shot, but nothing but net. Brandon Thomas from Northridge makes it 27-21. Jeremy Smith now. Dayton sets the screen high, and Smith goes to the drive, no good. Dayton keeps it alive. LeCou ends up with it. Henderson. Johnson's pass down low, intercepted. Scott. Davis. And from the corner, another one of those threes, no good. And Johnson doing a good job blocking out, gets that loose ball rebound. Jeremy Smith, surprised Dayton. Davis comes up with it. Three from the corner, got it. Darius Scott just waiting over there and put it in, 27-24. Smith calling out the play. Lob pass, Dayton. There's the help. Backdoor, LeCou counted and a foul. Media timeout coming up, and Richard LeCou will have a chance for a three-point play when we come back. 29-24 Coyotes.
Media timeout on the court. Here is the Spirit Squad.
6:37. Coyotes trying to get two at home this week. Came close to getting three on the road last week. Beat Academy of Art, beat Monterey Bay. I know Andy is still annoyed at the outcome of that East Bay game. Every time I look at that box score in my clippings when I get ready for a game, it annoys me too, so I know how he feels. They'll get another chance at the Pioneers here later in the year. So LeCou will be at the line. Coyotes at 65% shooting. And winning the battle with the boards 14-6. And the three throw is good. 30-24, San Bernardino. Thomas. Fennell. Three on the way and good. Boy, they are living from out there. Frankie Campbell put that one in. And three-point shooting. Stanislaw now 6 of 13 from out there. Henderson with the pass to Bulldog. Baseline around the defender and puts it in. 32-27. Via gets two. Scott. Salgado against Via. Salgado baseline and off from the goal. Out of bounds to the Coyotes. Cameron Brown back in the game for the Warriors. Coyotes by five. Mitchell, spin move. Pass back to Jeremy Smith. Good look inside the Bulldog, and it's stripped. Davis, crossover dribble, three, no. Mitchell coming back. Jeremy Smith will set him up. And a foul as Smith goes across. Brendan Thomas. Coyotes are in the bonus now. That was the seventh team foul. So Jeremy Smith will go to the line. Good look at Jeremy as he buries the first, averaging 17 a game. And there is the second. 34-27, Coyotes with the lead. Francois. Behind the stripe. Fennell against LeCou. Fennell to the left, put it up. Might have been partially blocked. Taken by the Coyotes. Smith. Henderson. Back to LeCou. A three straight away. Yes. 37-27. Nice ball movement. Coyotes go up by 10. Three in front of the Coyote. Three in front of the Coyote bench for Fennell. Rebound Mitchell. Henderson swings to the corner. Another three, no good. Rebound punched out to Jeremy Smith. And Smith underneath Mitchell. That shot blocked. 4 minutes to go, first half. Coyote foul. Actually, what did they call? He said white ball. So let's get that sorted out. Coyotes will have the ball. First of all, a timeout. And the Coyotes with the lead, 37-27 on KMET. Coyotes with a 10-point lead. Welcome to everybody looking in on the CCAA network tonight. Those of you listening on KMET Radio, it'll be a doubleheader Saturday afternoon, starting with Coyote basketball against Cal State San Marcos, 3 o'clock on AM 1490, the website and the apps. That'll be followed by Rams football from San Francisco. Rams and 49ers immediately following Coyote basketball on Saturday night. And then Sunday, we'll have an NBA doubleheader. Clippers at Oklahoma City, followed by Denver at the Lakers, all on KMET. 10-point lead.
Run it, Horn!
Coyotes working on that. And Smith, back door, swings it to Henderson. Off balance, off the front of the rim, got his own rebound, and powers it back up, no good. Bulldog got a hand on it. LeCoux keeps it alive, and Stanislaw ends up with it. Beno Cezic in the game for the first time. And Cezic backs it out. Salgado cross court. Cezic against Smith. From the free throw line, Francois won't drop. Smith with a rebound. 10-point game at the 3 minute mark of the first half. And Jeremy Smith will go all the way, and it's blocked by Francois. And Andy Newman thought surely that was a foul.
Came right down on him, Kendall.
17 on the shot clock.
Oh, you're going to get that one.
Offensive foul underneath on Via. .249 left first half. Cezic to Lavender. Carried it. Coyotes will take it. San Bernardino still shooting better than 60% so far. Stanislaw was up into the 40s, but now back to 35.
Hey, spot! 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 Spot!
Smith will get things set up again.
Go by. Sing.
Via down low, LeCoux in the corner. And Smith on the drive all the way, kicks it back out, surprised Henderson, who keeps it alive to Mitchell. And Mitchell in traffic, put it up and wouldn't drop. Rebound taken by the Warriors, and we got a Coyote foul. Villa with the foul. His second. So that's the seventh team foul on San Bernardino. That means three throws. Fennell gets the first. Another one coming. Nine in the game for Fennell. And it'll stay there as Jennings has the rebound. Coyotes have been stuck on 37 for a while. Mitchell down court and fouled on his way up. Fennell with the foul. First foul for Fennell. Jordan Mitchell for two. Three throw good. Coyotes right about 70% from the stripe this year as a team. Tonight, a little bit better than that. Four out of five so far. Jordan gets them both. 39-28, San Bernardino. Cezic. Here's Francois. And got it to go. Got Dayton off his feet. Nine-point San Bernardino lead. Coyote's going to spread the floor again. Henderson. Three-pointer no good. Rebound. And here come the Warriors with Davis. To Cezic. Travel. Minute 25 to go first half.
Round, right here. Thumb down.
Jennings posted down low. Laku in the corner again. Jennings. Off balance. Got it to go anyway. Tough shot. 41-30. Dayton Jennings. Making it look easy on that one. Under a minute to go. Cezic. Bounce pass. Fennell leads in contact, and he's going to go to the line. And Jenny just committed his second. Other games around the conference tonight. Sonoma at UC San Diego. Dominguez Hills hosting Cal State LA. And San Marcos is at Pomona. Four games on Saturday, a couple on Sunday, and then everybody will take the break. Fennell gets both of these, 41-32, San Bernardino. Smith with the play. Mitchell gives it back. And Jeremy backs it out at the three throw line. This is Henderson. Laku looking for Dayton. Shot clock at 10. And Smith from downtown, no good. And a foul on the rebound. Going to get Dayton for a push off. So his third. Nine team fouls. Brandon Thomas at the line. Shot clock turned off. 21 seconds to go, first half.
Shot clock has
Got it. Brown in the game for Stanislaw. The Coyotes up by 7 here. Should hold for the final shot. Mitchell against full court pressure. Jeremy Smith draws the double.
Go to score, go to score.
14 seconds left and a cross-court pass intercepted. Thomas, no good, but Fennell taps it in. 4 seconds left. Henderson from 30, no good. And the first half comes to an end. Coyotes led it by as many as 12. As they go to the locker room, it's a 5-point Coyote lead. Stick with us. We'll come back, tell you what else is going on around the CCAA tonight. All of the Warrior fans looking in tonight from Central California. We'll see you guys in February on an interesting trip. It'll start in Stanislaw and end in Arcata. There's a ton of miles between. Bulldogs pass intercepted off the turnover. Stanislaw, and they turn it over. Pass right through the hands of Fennell out of bounds. Usually, when the Coyotes play Humboldt, they play somebody like Sonoma or one of the other schools on the way up. Usually when they play Stanislaw, they play Chico, but they don't go to Chico this year. So they're doing Stanislaw and Humboldt on the same trip in February. Henderson with the pass. Jennings in the corner, now goes to the baseline. Shot is up and in, but it is not going to count. Offensive foul, his fourth. First team foul in the second half. So Dayton Jennings with 4 points and 6 rebounds, but on the bench with his fourth foul. And Francois down low scores and is fouled. And Bulldog just picked up his third. So Xavier Francois will shoot the free throw. Free throw good. And that's the closest that Stanislaw has been in a while. 41-39. Mitchell to Henderson. LeCoux out in front. Recovers. And Henderson traveled. Back-to-back Coyote turnovers. 14 in the game. Paul Trevor now up coaching his team, knowing that he's got a chance to tie or get the lead this time down. Fennell. Scott. Good pass back door. Missed layup, but a foul. I thought that was after the shot, but let's see. Fennell's going to go to the line. And Villa just picked up his fourth. So Fennell will go to the line. First is good. Now Darnell Johnson is going to get another opportunity here. We mentioned he's trying to fill that spot and be the eighth man in the rotation with Clark out for the year. The nice thing about Darnell is the free throw is good. He's a tweener. He's 6'6", 200 pounds. So you can use him in a couple different roles. And with both of the big guys, except LeCoux, out of the game with foul trouble, they're going to put him down low. Mitchell with the ball. Mitchell spins off a defender, throws it in off the glass. 43-41. Coyotes working on defense. And Fennell with a three. That's good. And the Warriors take the lead, 44-43. So Stanislaw battling back. Henderson, Mitchell from the corner, hits a three-pointer. And the Coyotes take it back. Davis, Francois down low, against LeCoux, no good.
How is that not a travel, Matt?
Smith, LeCoux banging down low. Johnson running the baseline now. Smith, right side. Drags the defender, 10 on the shot clock. Mitchell to the basket, and the ball deflected by Salgado. Coming back off the turnover, and Francois lays it in. 46-44. Paul Trevor now up near midcourt telling his team, hey, now let's go. Tied at 46. It's like the Coyotes lost any momentum they had at halftime in that five-point lead in his first 3 minutes here with foul trouble by Villa and Jennings, and foul whistled here on Salgado. Rax back in the game for the Coyotes. And it'll be Jeremy Smith at the free throw line. Coyotes talking over defensive assignments here. So Smith will be at the line. He is ready. Officials are ready. And those of you on video getting a good look at Jeremy as he puts in the three throw. 47-46, Coyotes.
You got 14.
See what the Coyotes did as far as matchup. Second free throw missed. Scott. Davis. Fennell. Double teamed. Cross court pass intercepted. Mitchell coming back. 2-on-1. And Mitchell goes all the way and lays it in. 49-46, Coyotes. Davis. Fennell. 18 on the clock. Fennell takes it again now. Shot clock at 10. Scott, turnaround, yes. 49-48 as Darius Scott connects. 49-48. Mentioned Stanislaus' starters do almost all of their scoring. None of them are in foul trouble, so no real reason they can't play most of his second half. Smith, LeCoux, and a foul on his way to the basket on Francois. That's going to get us to the media timeout. 15:33 remaining. Coyotes with a one-point lead. It's 49-48 in Casulas on KMET. Okay, good.
All right, you guys, it's time for our Raising Cane's half-court shot. I'm having Xavier and Rebecca. Come on out, you guys. So Xavier's going to go first tonight. He needs 3 seconds to warm up. He's nervous. All right, I'm going, Xavier. 3, 2, 1, go.
Coyote basketball brought to you by the Hilton Garden Inn in Rancho Cucamonga and by Pepsi. San Bernardino leads by one. Jeremy Smith's got 15 points. Jordan Mitchell has 13. Villa and Jennings both in foul trouble with four apiece. Fennell up to 18 now for Stanislaw, and Darius Scott has 11. 15 Coyote turnovers tonight. And it'll be Richard LeCoux at the free throw line. LeCoux, the 6'9 transfer from McNeese State. Free throw good. Originally from Dallas. Second one won't go down. 50-48, Coyotes. Davis, Salgado. Good ball movement by Stanislaw. Scott, back door. Fennell's got it and is going to have a chance for a three-point play. A layup and a foul. Henderson with the foul. And Fennell. Makes the free throw. 51-50. Stanislaus. Paul Trevor telling his team one stop. Coyotes meanwhile trying to get the lead back. Rax. There's the three-pointer short. They can get him going. That could change things too. Davis. There's Fennell. Henderson working on him. Davis goes into the near corner now. Shot clock at 10. Salgado straight away, three, halfway down, wouldn't fall. Rax. And a touch foul on Brown. .14:27 remaining. Jeremy Smith, left to right. Mitchell will take it. Free throw line, spinner off the glass, no. Davis will set things up for the Warriors. 14 minutes to go. Scott directing traffic. Launches a three, no good. LeCoux with the rebound. Smith. All the way, layup, good. Andy Newman wanted the foul on that too, and it wasn't called. 52-51. And we got an injury timeout here. Fennell is okay. He's going to stay in the game. Fennell posted down low. Now they give it to him. Scott for three. No. Rebound, Henderson. Tyrell. Smith fakes the three. His pass deflected. Two-on-one break for Stanislaw. And they lose it out of bounds. Wow. Hey, 13 minutes to go. Francois will return on the next dead ball. LeCoux posted high. Now drops down low. Mitchell with it, in traffic, spin move, counted and a foul. Why, Mitchell has really stepped up when the Coyotes have needed the second score tonight, with Jennings and Villas hampered by fouls. Jordan Mitchell now has 15 with a free throw to come. Mitchell ready for the free throw. That's too long. Rebound is loose. And off to Scott for Stanislav. This game is here for the taking for either one of these teams. Davis. Scott. Fennell gives it back. Two-man game for the moment. Davis. Shot clock at 3, and they're not going to get it off. First shot clock violation of the night. Paul Trevor not pleased about that one. Coyotes by 3. Smith just called the play out. LeCoux at the free throw line. Mitchell gets the screen. Lob pass to LeCoux, out of bounds, it'll stay with San Bernardino. And there's the media timeout. 12 minutes remaining. Still anybody's ballgame. 54-51 San Bernardino on KMET. Minutes remaining. Mitch McClellan with you at Casulis Arena, where the Coyotes now have 3 men in double figures. Smith with 17, Mitchell with 15, LeCoux with 10. 21 for Fennell and 11 for Scott. Stanislav's leading two. Coyotes shooting in the second half, 5 out of 8. Stanislav, 5 out of 9. Coyote ball out of bounds. Smith finds Henderson and gets it right back. Smith left side three-pointer in front of the Coyote bench on the drive and will go to the line. Boy, Jeremy Smith, that is a great weapon to have if you need points. Somebody that can drive to the basket and then go to the line. Francois with his third personal. The fifth team foul on Stanislav. Smith's free throw good. Coyote lead to 4, 55-51. Got them both. Coyotes by 5, looking for a stop. Now Fennell is going to drop down low right now. Sets the screen. There's the pass to Francois. LeCun doing a good job. That looked like a travel, not called. Rebound Coyotes. And Jeremy Smith will back it out. Andy Newman saying, take your time. Smith on the drive again. Pass to Mitchell. Mitchell with a little spinner. And that pass deflected will stay with the Coyotes. 11 on the shot clock. The guys that are making points right now are the guys that are creating shots. Henderson, a good example there. He's not feeding an open jumper. These are guys that are creating contact, going to the basket both ways. Henderson gets it up to a 7-point Coyote lead. 58-51. Davis. Right side. Fennell sent it right back out. From the corner, got it. That was a jump shot. Hadn't seen one of those in a while, and Fennell buried it, 58-54. Andy Newman not happy. His team had a 7-point lead cut in half. A full timeout, says Mike Adams. So we're going to take a full timeout as well. 58-54, Coyotes with the lead. We're back after this. .47 to go. Coyote ball, a 7-point lead down to 4. Mitchell to inbound. Full court pressure. Rax comes to help. And Rax will just bring it up himself. They have not been able to get him going tonight so far. Smith out high, double stack, bounce pass to Henderson. Mitchell with 9 on the clock. And Henderson measures a 3, that's good. 61-54, Coyotes. As we near the 10-minute mark. Scott, there's Fennell. Shot clock at 15. Long three. That's good for Davis. 61-57. Both teams using some time on each possession now. 9:40. And a lob to LeCoux, but he couldn't handle. And Davis. Offensive foul. Kevin Smith called it on Fennell. His second personal. 6th team foul. Coyotes will be in the bonus on the next one. .932 remaining. Coyotes with Mitchell, Smith, Rax. Jennings just came back in the game with his 4th foul. And Henderson. Mitchell Henderson gives it back. Now Smith. Bounce pass to Dayton. Jennings on the dribble. Dayton working down low. And his pass delivered underneath, off the glass, no good. Rebound and taken by Davis. Davis coming back all the way, throws it up, wouldn't drop. Rebound is loose. Follow won't go, but the second one does. Plenty of work on the offensive glass by Stanislaus, 61-59. .840 remaining. Jennings at the high post, facing the basket, working on Francois, and they foul. Francois will pick it up. So Francois becomes the first Warrior to get the four. Jennings at the line, free throw won't drop. Salgado returns for the Warriors. Jennings will try to get the second here. Can't do it. 61-59. Coyote three throw shooting has not been good in the second half either. Three-pointer from the corner for the lead is good. 62-61, Stanislaus. .805 remaining. Mitchell. Back to Rax. Open is Jeremy Smith for the three. No. Foul on the rebound over the back. It's going to stay down here. That foul on Ty Davis. His second timeout on the court. 7:52 remaining. 62-61. It continues to be a one possession game, and we're back after this. .722 to go. Coyotes talking it over in the huddle. Fennell's got 24 in the game now for Stanislaus to lead all scorers. Jeremy Smith has 19 for the Coyotes. Coyotes still out rebounding them 28-21, but they've turned it over 17 times. And they are shooting 9 of 15 from the line so far tonight. Andy Newman looking at those same numbers I just gave you. Henderson got the first on the one and one, so a second to come. Got them both. Coyotes get the lead back, 63-62. Davis, Fennell, Davis, two-man game, Fennell off the screen for three. And feeling it now, 63-62. Mitchell with the turnover. Davis in the corner, three no good. Well, I thought Davis got that one. Now Smith coming back, and Smith leans in, got it. Tied at 65. 7 minutes left. Fennell. Scott, good pass underneath. Salgado lays it in. On the back door. 67-65. Smith, contact. Counts if it goes. It does. Chance for a three-point play. Thomas with the foul. Bulldog back in the game with the four fouls for San Bernardino. Cameron Brown, the freshman from Cajon High School here in town, returns for Stanislaw. Three throw good. Jeremy's got 22 to the night for the Coyotes. 68-67. Davis, back door wide open, Fennell. 68-67. Somebody blew a defensive coverage. Or the Coyotes didn't know what defense they were in. That might be a better explanation. Racks for three, yes. 71-69. And now Scott, no good. Bulldog grabs the rebound. Under 6 minutes left. Smith, Bulldog sets a screen. Smith around it, lost the dribble. Loose ball. And Bulldog trying to pick it up, just committed his fifth. LeCou into the game. .540 remaining. 71-69, San Bernardino. Salgado, left side. Davis, Fennell, double team, ball stripped. He fights to get it back, knocked out of bounds. It'll stay down there. 16 seconds Davis. Left.
Davis, can you look at it? That was off of him. That was off of 21. And Davis, are you allowed to throw your head back if you're not getting fouled? No, him, 21. He just did that. That's a flop.
Inbound pass, Davis. Against LeCou. Back out for the three. No. Rebound. Brown. Back out to Fennell. Yes. 72-71. Five minutes left. Mitchell with a free throw line. Back to Rax for three. No. And a rebound to Salgado. Coyotes down by one. Stanislaw looking for a good shot here. Fennell guarded by Henderson. Now drops down low. Left side, eight on the shot clock for Scott. Cross court pass. And they put it up to beat the clock. No good. Jeremy Smith coming back in a hurry. And through Mitchell's hands, out of bounds. 4:17 remaining. I just have a feeling this is not going to be the Coyotes' night. Hope I'm wrong. 72-71. Daytona comes into the game. Rax is going to leave. So LeCoux and Jennings both in together. Just over 4 minutes to go. Fennell backing in, draws the double. Shot clock at 15 for Davis. Salgado bounces it. Scott off balance and a foul. He'll go to the line. And we'll have a media timeout. 3:53 remaining, and it's a 72-71 game. Stanislaw leading San Bernardino on KMET. If you're going to make the conference tournament, if you're going to finish near the top of the conference, these are the kind of games you have to find a way to win. And this is what separates teams that are good from teams that are normal or near 500. End of the year, we'll find out what both these teams turned out to be. But games like this will play a big part to deciding it. This is the kind of a game the Coyotes lost Thursday at East Bay. So Villa out of the game with four fouls. Andy Newman with the pen in hand diagramming the play. In the second half tonight, San Bernardino shooting 62%. Stanislaw 54%. The difference... Stanislaw is 14 of 15 on their three throws. The Coyotes are 12 of 18. Coyotes have also turned it over seven more times, 20 for the game. Darius Scott will go to the three throw line. And Scott misses from the line for the first time tonight. Got that one, 73-71, Stanislaw. That might be their biggest lead tonight. 3:49 remaining. Daytona sets a screen. Henderson with 19 on the clock. Smith across court pass, they go down low. LeCoux tied up, jump ball. Possession arrow goes to Stanislaw. Stop. 3:35 left. Davis. Now they go left. Fennell calling for it. They bounce it to him. Double teamed. Now Fennell's got it from the corner. No good. And Henderson grabbed the rebound and a foul underneath. They got LeCou. His third. So three throws coming up for Salgado. One and one. Luis Salgado first on the way and good. Salgado perfect from the line tonight. Got them both. Stanislaw by four, 75-71. And the Coyotes need some offense in a hurry. Smith for three, got it. And Andy Newman is going to call the quick timeout. 75-74. Boy, did they need that. 30-second timeout with 3:08 to go. We'll keep it here. Again, Saturday, a 3 o'clock game at Casulas. It'll start at 1. And by the way, if you're around town, bring the family. The kids are free. Adults get in for $3. Women's game at 1. Men's game at 3. We'll have it for you on KMET and the CCAA network. And then for those of you on KMET radio following that, it'll be Rams 49ers football from Santa Clara. Stanislaw came in with a 3-2 conference record. San Bernardino 2-2. Both these teams needing to win this game. Coyotes led it most of the way, but that doesn't mean anything now. They led it East Bay most of the way, too. 75-74. Salgado's pass inside, knocked away. Intended for Fennell, Smith knocked it away. Coyotes in the front court. LeCou for three, got it. Coyotes get the lead, 77-75, and now they look for the stop. 2.5 minutes remaining. Salgado with a pass down low to Fennell. Back to Salgado for three. No. Rebound out high. Mitchell's got it. Jeremy Smith will walk it up. Coyotes can be patient here. Get a good shot. Shot clock at 20. Mitchell takes the handoff. Mitchell back to Smith. Dayton calling for it down low. And popped out to take it. And it's knocked out of bounds. 12 on the shot clock. It'll stay with San Bernardino. Francois back in the game. Mitchell will inbound in front of the Coyote bench. Bounce pass to Dayton in the corner. Shot clock at 10. Double teamed. Pass to Mitchell. He goes underneath. LeCou lays it in. Good pass by Mitchell. 79-75 San Bernardino. A minute 48 to go. Fennell. Entry pass. Francois back it in all the way. Put it up, no good. Rebound Dayton, and Andy says, hold on, slow it down. A minute 35 to go. Smith walks it down. Smith with 20, backs it out. Good call. Minute 20 to go. Mitchell with 10 on the clock. Mitchell inside, little hook shot, no good. And a foul on the rebound. They did not need that. It's a not a good foul on Mitchell. Wendy Newman is saying the same thing. We did not need that.
Hey, one and one. One and one, rebound, two
Francois at the line. This is a 1-1, and the three throw is good. Another one coming up. There's the second. That's good. 79-77, Coyotes. Smith and Mitchell in the backcourt. Wild pass. Smith gets it across to Henderson. A minute remaining. Coyotes by two. 15 on the shot clock. Mitchell kicking it down. Now it's to Smith. Smith to the basket all the way. Put it up and a foul. Ty Davis got him. Jeremy Smith will go to the line with 53 seconds left. This will be a two-shot foul. Smith, free throw, no good off the rim. Andy Newman with a wince on the bench. One of two, 80-77, Coyotes. One minute 50 seconds to go. Fennell with the pass. And down low, count it, and a foul. Francois put it in. LeCou was there. His fourth. So 43 seconds left. And Francois trying to tie it. Missed it. And Mitchell has the rebound. 37 seconds left. Smith in the front court. Shot clock at 20. Coyotes with a 1-point lead. Smith calls timeout. So 27 seconds to go in the game. Shot clock is at 14, and Andy says they want it to be a 30-second timeout. So it's 80-79, San Bernardino. As you go back and look, Coyotes have scored 7 points in the last 3.5 minutes. Andy's got the clipboard out. You got to think that this is going to involve Jeremy Smith driving to the basket. If not Jeremy Smith, then Jordan Mitchell. One-point game. 14 on the shot clock, and they're going to inbound right next to the Coyote bench where we are. Mitchell will send it in. Mitchell looking at Jeremy Smith and gets it to him in the backcourt. Shot clock is at 10 right now. And Smith with it over to Henderson. Henderson, pass down low, intercepted. Could have shot it, made the pass instead. Long pass down low to Fennell, and he stepped out of bounds. Wow, how lucky can you be? Coyote ball out of bounds. That could have been a 4-point switch. And the Coyotes came out of it as well as they possibly could have. 11.8 seconds left. San Bernardino by one. Mitchell inbound against full court pressure. Looking. And Rax takes the inbound. Throws it back. Smith has got it. And Smith is fouled with 6.8 seconds left. Dayton Jennings will come back into the game. And a full timeout now called on the court. So 80-79. Coyotes trying to hang on here at home. Coyotes are checking the timeouts and also checking where they're going to inbound the ball at. Andy Newman in the huddle again, pen in hand as he diagrams on the clipboard. And again, I gotta think they want it in the hands of Jeremy Smith, if at all possible. He has gotta be your number one option here. Pomona beat San Marcos, 78-59. They're just starting the second half at Cal State LA, or at Cal State Dominguez Hills. .8 seconds to go here. Jeremy Smith at the free throw line. Needs them both. Coyotes have a 1-point lead. And Smith's first is good. 81-79 Coyotes. They need this one, and then they don't need a three-pointer. In fact, Andy just said no threes. Jeremy's second is good. 82-79, no fouls. 6.8 seconds left. Davis in the front court. An off-balance three is up. It's an air ball out of bounds. This game is over. 82-79, San Bernardino. And it was not pretty, but the Coyotes will take it. 82-79, the final score. And a game they really needed. Now they keep the momentum up. And now they've got something to build on as they go in to Saturday afternoon against San Marcos. .82-79, the final score. And we'll take a break.